Hello friends, welcome to TechVedas. Friends, in the part 1 of this series, we had started with introduction of CAN protocol, where we had highlighted its features, need and its applications. In today's session, we are going to talk about CAN layered architecture, various standards available under 11898 family and different CAN versions. This video will be quite important to understand CAN protocol in detail. So before going further, if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it for all upcoming updates on embedded system. So let's start. Before jumping to CAN architecture, we need to understand the OSI model first. OSI or Open System Interconnection model is a conceptual model that partitions a communication system into 7 abstraction layers. It also defines the communication function of each layer, irrespective of the underlying internal structure and technology. According to OSI reference model, the CAN architecture defines 2 layers, data link and physical. Let's try to understand the functions of these 2 layers in more detail. Data link layer is responsible for node-to-node data transfer. It defines the protocol to establish and terminate the connection, and also responsible for detecting and possibly correcting the error that may occur at the physical layer. Data link layer is divided into 2 sublayers: MAC, which defines how devices in a network gain access to the medium, encapsulation and decapsulation of the data, error detection and signaling. And logical link control is responsible for frame acceptance filtering, overload notification and recovery management. Physical layer is responsible for the transmission and reception of raw data. It defines the specification for parameters such as voltage level, timing, data rates and connector. CAN specification defines CAN protocol and CAN physical layer, which are defined in CAN standard ISO 11898. Friends, ISO 11898 has 3 parts. Part 1, which covers the specification for data link layer and physical signaling. Part 2 and 3 covers the CAN physical layer for high speed and low speed CAN respectively. Low speed CAN allows data rate up to 125 kbps, which is used where the speed of communication is not a critical factor. And high speed CAN allows data rate up to 1 mbps, which is primarily used in the powertrain and chassis area of the vehicle. CIA stands for CAN in Automation, which defines the specification for CAN connector. As far as the implementation is concerned, CAN controller and transceiver are implemented in the software with the help of application, operating system and network management functions. Now let's talk about CAN versions. There are several versions of CAN specification got published, among which the latest is CAN 2.0, which was released in 1991. This specification has 2 parts. Part A is for the standard format with an 11-bit identifier, and Part B is for the extended format with an 29-bit identifier. So friends, here we come to end of this video. Let me know your feedback in the comment box. And for all upcoming updates, don't forget to subscribe my channel techvedas.learn. Thanks for watching. Hope you like it.